own kit. But what we ended up doing is we kind of made our own blood recipe, and in the blood recipe we ended up mixing a lot of dishwashing soap, like Dawn kind of thing.
So it's already half lifted once it goes in.
Exactly. So when you're applying it to the costume, there's already soap in the blood, and then it becomes much, much easier to wash away because it's soap is part of what it's doing. So again, here I think Google would be your friend where... You might have to do a little bit of a two-for-one kind of thing. So you put blood... Yeah, exactly. You put certain blood on fabric and then a different type of blood on your skin. I think that that would be the best way to get like the best of both worlds. It's a little bit more work on your part, but that way your skin won't be irritated and your costume will wash off.
Yeah, and I mean, always make sure that whatever you're putting on your skin doesn't hurt. Because if it's a mild irritation to begin with, if you wear it all day, it will not be a mild irritation at the end of the day.
I've had problems where I've used products that are not good for my skin, and I use them without gloves, and I'm like, oh, it's like a little bit of cheap or whatever, and then the next day, like,
my hands are baking with you, right?
Actually, they like the skin on the palms of my hands just peeled away.
Oh,
I'm super gross. Don't do that.
I am allergic to something that raw denim is treated with, and I will handle it. But I used to work in a fabric store, and I would handle it, and then I'd go home, and the next day I'd look like I was wearing like big pink mittens because my hands would swell and then turn bright red. And it was just like, oh, well, it's just a mild irritation. I'll just keep working with it. Yeah, but I
don't know. Don't do that. Sir in red, you look like you had a question.
Yeah, I do like a
okay, so you have a couple options here.
I'll take you to this one.
Okay, so...